Welcome to our channel Right Click Education. In today's video we will learn how we can implement Angular Materials slider. So let's get to the video. Open your Chrome, type Angular Material. Open material.angular.io, the official website of Angular Material. Click on components. In the side navbar you can see all Angular Material components. So click on this slider. So you can see by the definition, match slider allows for the selection of a value from range via mouse, touch or keyboard. So if you see, we can scroll it, and according to the scroll, it has certain values that is attached to it. So it works like input type range. Okay, so let's implement it. Click on API, copy this match slider module, copy it, go to your VS Code, open app.module.ts, paste it, match slider module, copy this match slider module, under the ng module import section, paste it. So the import part is done. Now go to example. We will implement this. We will implement this match slider. So let's copy this match slider. Okay, go to your app.component.html, paste it. Now let's go to our localhost 4200 and see what all is there. So you can see, right, this is a slider. You can scroll it, right? So if you are here, suppose you can assume it's 50% of the scrolling, right? So the progress is of 50%, or the value is 50. So you can determine this. Now we can add some more properties to this slider to see how we can customize this. Okay, in order to do that, go to your official website, click on example, click on view code. So scroll down, you can see, right, these all properties are there. So copy this one, go to your VS Code and app.component.html, paste it. So you can see this match slider has disabled property, invert property, max value of the slider, mean value of the slider. We have something called vertical, whether it is vertical slider or horizontal slider. Remove this method, we don't need this. We can just copy this tick interval, paste it. Okay, now we need to define all these properties, mean, max, invert, right, in this app.component.ts. So let's go to official website again, scroll up, go to TS. You can see all these properties are here, right? So you can copy all these properties. Go to your VS Code, open app.component.ts, paste it. So now you can see, right, autotick is false, disabled is false, max is 100, mean is 0, so ticks is false, value is 0. Okay, this vertical is false, so it will be horizontally, vertical is false, right? So what we will do, we will just put a mat label. Okay, the value is, we will bind the value property here. Okay, So we have binded it. Now let's go to our UI and see. So if you see, now the value is 0. As I scroll it, you can see the now value is 15, right? The value is 33. If I do it extreme top, extreme right, it's 100, right? So in this way, you can change the value. Now let's also change some of the properties. So right now, vertical is vertical, and this vertical is, I think, false, right? Now let's make it true, right? So if we make it true, now let's see. If you see, right, now this slider has become vertical, and as you scroll up, this value is getting changed, right? The value is 25, value is 40, value is 73, value is 100, because this is the max value, right? And now let's again make it to false. Also check this disabled property. So suppose we make it as true. Now let's see. Now you cannot do anything here, right? So because this slider has been disabled, now let's make it true again. Sorry, false again. Now let's change the mean and max. Suppose mean is 20, max is 120. Okay, so now let's see. Now let's, so you can see in the extreme right it is 120, in the extreme left it is 20, right? So the mean and max value is also changed. So in this way you can implement your Angular Materials slider, and you can customize Angular Materials slider by using some properties like max, mean, disabled, vertical. So those all property you can customize, right? So that's it for this video. If you haven't subscribed our channel, please do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get more update. Thanks and have a nice day.